Namaste everyone, Anna Chabra here. Today morning I have done a lot of pruning to a few of my plants. Basically your bougainvillea, giloy and Mexican sunflower. So as we all know that once we start gardening, every few days pruning is must. But now monsoon time is really good for pruning to these kind of plants. So they'll get new branches and it will become more bushy, and again when the season comes they'll be flowering more. So now once we do the pruning, few things you have to keep it in mind while doing the pruning and after the pruning, what all things you get collected and then how to use them. Few people after the pruning, they'll throw away everything. That is the worst thing we should not do, because this is a real good source for our gardening, especially when we talk about organic gardening. So morning when I have done the pruning, everything I had kept it aside, because at the same time everything I can't do, that much time won't be there. So I just kept it aside, whatever I had pruned it, and then leisurely I have to check the plants. Now suppose this stem is there, in this some part is green, whereas the lower part you will see it will be little on a brownish side. Okay, so when I do the pruning, I make sure how much ever cuttings I can save to make them separately as a new plant. So this is the right time for propagation also, and this is the right time for pruning also. So once I do the pruning, I make sure I'll sort it out, the twigs or the stems which can be regrown again. So if I need it for myself, how much ever the plants, I'll keep it, I'll share it with my friends, or I have a small farm, I'll send it there. So depends how you use it. So the first thing before pruning is make sure you sterilize your scissors or knife, whatever you use. Make sure once you have used this for one plant, again you sterilize it with the whatever your surgical spirit or anything, so that this infection from one plant to the other plant, it should not go. Each time when you shift to the plant, you wipe it nicely with your any sterilizer, whatever you use. Okay, now once you have separated the things which you don't want, in this these are the things, the leaves, the twigs, the green color stems and all, which cannot be propagated. So that is one section. The second one is the ones which I can use it for regrowing or can be used for stem propagation. So in that you have to make sure, whenever now from one branch so many branches will cut, so we tend to forget which is the top part and which is the lower part which has to go in the soil, because we are going to remove the leaves. So make sure whenever you do that, the down part always give a slant cut, okay, and the top part always give a flat cut. So even after a day, or sometimes you will see this, it will be very much clear that this part goes in the soil and this is the top part. So this is one. So we have segregated the one which we don't want at present. Second thing, we have done the cutting. Now whatever cuttings I need, in that what I'll do, whatever the extra leaves are there, extra branches are there, I'll cut it, and only one or two leaves each branch will be more than fine. Okay, now make sure when you have done the cutting here and the cutting here, straight and slant. If this much part is done, this is done. Now what to be done? These are the very nice cuttings which can be propagated. So immediately what I do, I take a bucket in which little water and little Jeevamrita I have added, as Jeevamrita is very good for the root propagation, and I add to this few cut. I have taken one stem of aloe vera, I cut it into smaller pieces. This is antifungal, so anything problem with our stem or anything, so it can be. Now just one piece I'll keep it with me. Now suppose I take one stem. Now as I told you, this part goes down and this is the top part, so I'm going to immerse this like this. So this part might get infection of any thing. So in this, two things you can do. One is either you can apply some cinnamon powder or turmeric powder of nothing if you have. Just a soil also you can take and you can apply that. What I do is, I just take my stem. This is the part which goes down. The part which will be up, I just rub little aloe vera on that. Now it has an antifungal property, so no infection will be there. Now this way it goes in my bucket. Let me do few more so it will be clear to you. This is the slant one, this is the round one. So the slant one anyways it's going in Jivamrita, so that antifungal property is there, so no tension for that. So like this, all the branches I'll do, and I keep it in this for minimum 4 to 5 hours. Okay, so like this everything will go. Once all are over, I can put this also in the water, so why to waste it. So now this way it will be there in this Jivamrita water for 4 to 5 hours. After 4 to 5 hours, they are ready for putting in the soil, because the moisture content will also be good, because if I'll keep it like this, they'll get dried. In this, the moisture content also will be there, the rooting hormone also, it has gone inside that, antifungal property also is there. So every you can say in every aspect the stem is ready, safe, and you can say it's easier for us to go to the next step. Now for the potting mix. Now I have taken equal quantities of soil, compost and cocoa peat. Yesterday only, because I had planned to do the pruning today, so yesterday only I had made the potting mix, I had watered it and kept it. So you can see it is neither wet nor moist, nor dry. Okay, so it's exactly what I wanted, is you can say it's moist. Now once you have kept your twigs inside this Jivamrita water, so we have kept our soil ready, the twigs are, these stems are also ready. So just take out your stem and just scrape this little bit. Okay, after scraping, dip it again in this water and push it in the soil. As the soil is little moist, it will go aram se, it will go very smoothly in the soil. This way the other stick stems also you can put it in the soil. Now after putting all the stems, you can water it and keep it in a semi shaded area for at least a week or 10 days. During that time, avoid shifting of this pot, because whenever we do the stem cutting, the stem does not like to be too much of displacement. So little bit of air pockets, if it forms in the soil, the propagation will not be successful. So make sure whenever you have done this, keep it in a place where you don't have to shift it. Rainwater should not fall on this. Indirect sunlight, or even if it's a shady place, that also not an issue. Watering also every 2 to 3 days, just sprinkle little water. During this stage, it does not need much water. After 10 to 15 days, yeah, you can see small, these wherever the joints are there, from there tiny shoots will be visible. That is the time it can be shifted little to the brighter or indirect sunlight area. And when you see still more shoots like this kind of a leaves are visible, that is the stage we can transplant it, and then that is the right time to keep it in the sunlight. So the process from this stage till the time it will get this much leaves, it might take 1.5 to 2 months. During the rainy season, yeah, within 2 months it will be ready, but other seasons it might take more than 2.5 months also. But during that time, make sure every time you are not going to shift the pot. Light displacement also might create problem for the stems to get propagated. So this is one thing. The second thing is, whenever you do the propagation from the stem, make sure the stem should not be too thick also, neither it should be too thin also. Okay, the 90 to 95% success we get when the size of the stem is almost equal to our pencil or pen size. okay. So that is one thing. And any stem which has more of greener texture, or that means the soft wood texture, that will not get propagated. So don't select that. And remove all the leaves. Make sure one or two leaves, if it is there, not an issue. Too much of extra branches and leaves you have to remove. Now this is what we want from our plant after the pruning. So this was the section. This we have to concentrate first, because this, if you keep on delaying after a day or two, the stems will not be able to get propagated. So this is the first thing what we have to do once we do the pruning. Now this is done. Now what to do with the stems and the leaves, what we don't want to get propagated, or it cannot be propagated. So those things we can let it dry for a day or two, and then we can, if you have a less number, then in a small grow bag or something, you can fill it and keep it aside to let it further dry. Or if you have more quantity, then you can take a bigger plastic bag or something, and then you can put it inside that. But before putting these things into this, make sure they are completely dried. Otherwise, fungal infection will be there. Too much of fungal growth will be there. Ants will come. So it will be difficult for you to manage. So make sure whenever you do the pruning, the things which we don't want, spread it nicely. Let it dry completely. So now what, once we have dried it, we have stored it. Now how to use it? There are different ways. This is a really good source for our organic terrace gardening. Now how to use it? The first thing is, once it is dried, you can use it as mulch also. You just crush your leaves as a mulching. You can use it to your plants. Secondly, you can use it as, every time I tell, whenever we make a potting mix or we prepare our pot. So 1/3 of our pot should be with dry leaves and twigs for the proper drainage thing. So that goes inside that. So that is also one source. Thirdly, as we all do composting, and in which the aerobic composting and vermicomposting, for both of them, for aerobic composting it is used as carbon source, because every time whenever the kitchen waste we are putting in our composting bin, we need some dry matter. So when it is dried, it can be used for that. For our vermicomposting, for making the beds, worm bed, whenever we make, we need dry leaves and twigs, that is also required. Thirdly, one more thing is leaf manure or leaf compost. Suppose after all this, still you are left with something, so you can start doing leaf composting also. In that, nothing you have to do, you just pile up your this dry leaves and twigs in one bag, and occasionally you spray your Jivamrita on that. So the nature will take care of itself, and after you can save 3 to 4 months, you'll get a rich, nice black compost, which is very good for your plants because it has too much of humus content. So because of that, the moisture content of your soil will be too good, and it does not require too much of watering. So leaf mulch is really good, leaf compost is good, and for bedding and all, everything we use this. So the, and apart from that, I had done the pruning for giloy also. So too much giloy, this much we cannot consume immediately. So what I do, I just spread it in sun. So I let it dry little, and then I cut it into smaller pieces. And no need to make it powder, because once it is dried completely, I just cut it into smaller pieces. And whenever I make kashaya or kadha, in that I use this. So it's a very good for your immunity. You can say it's a good immunity booster. So it's up to you how you want. In the market, you get powdered form also. So if you want, you can. These stems are really too good. So you can cut it, dry it, and you can powder it, and you can store also. Or I prefer using it in a stem form, in a dried form. So that way also you can use. So whenever you plan to prune, so make sure you have a set of plants. Don't do everything together. Then what will happen? We land up wasting too much of thing, and we throw many things which are a very good source for our terrace garden. So plan, do few plants at once, so you can sort out the things that this is the way I have to manage my whatever the pruning is done. So this is a very systematic approach. Go slow and very nice, and don't waste anything, whatever is so much effort you have put in to grow all this. So but it's a nature's call. We have to prune it to make our plants more bushier. And moreover, the rainy season, as I every time tell, the bougainvillea gives flowering more when the soil is dry. So now the season is more towards rainy season, so the soil will always be moist, so flowering will be less, so this and more green leaves will be there in the plant. So this is the right time to prune this, so that more branches will come. Once the rainy season is over, this plant will be full of flowers. So just think accordingly, plan accordingly, and do it. So thank you very much for joining me. I hope this session will help you in this rainy season to plan your garden. Thank you very much. Keep watching.